Thank you, darling. Yeah, some say revenge is a dish best served cold.
So whatever happened to that Bob guy you were after?
Personally, I'd like to hear some of your other adventures. Like, I don't know, do you ever go toe-to-toe with a red man?
Yes, I did, Ben. I remember once I was after this renegade Apache, Grey Wolf. Strangely enough, revenge was also his primary motivation. A bounty was put on Grey Wolf's head, and that's how I came to hunt him in the mountains. Mountains so high, they tickled the nether regions of heaven. Grey Wolf was a Chiricahua Apache medicine man who had led a war party in revenge for a massacre against his people. The U.S. Army had attacked his tribe during his daughter's sacred sunrise ceremony, and the slaughter was unspeakable. I understood his anger, as there's nothing more traumatic than seeing those you love die in a cruel and painful death. Right from the beginning, I couldn't shake the feeling that Grey Wolf was watching my every move. He led a band of young Apache warriors who wanted retribution and were more than willing to die for him. They saw me before I saw them. And it crossed my mind that maybe this wasn't such a good idea. But now that the shooting has started, there was no backing down. Rugged country, the winter home of the Chiricahuas, and that's why they had retreated there. I admit to having some regrets about going after them the way I did. But then again, got a lot of those. Not at that moment, but I did find the entrance to their hideout. deep crevice that led to a deeper cave.
Don't tell me you're in there.
Yeah, but it's not out of bravery so much as pure, angry cussedness. See, back then, I had a stubborn streak a mile wide, and I wasn't about to back down.
So it was like pitch black in there?
Actually, it was pretty well lit, as they had torches on the wall.
How big was his cave?
Big as hell, Ben. Chiricahua had hid out there during the Indian Wars. They thought it was haunted with the ghosts of those murdered by the horse soldiers.
The cave was haunted with dead Indian ghosts?
To be honest, I was more concerned with the live ones than the dead ones.
You know so much about engines?
A few years back, I was married to two Mescalero women.
At the same time?
Yeah, they were sisters. Polygyny is traditional among the Mescalero.
So what happened?
Oh, I had to get out of there. Those girls never shut up. Both of them nagging at me all the time. Drove me half crazy. Haven't seen them since.
No, I mean, what happened with Grey Wolf?
Oh, well, I pursued him into the Cave of Death. I came upon this flooded grotto, and that's when I saw him. He came to me unarmed and unafraid. His voice echoed in the shadows, and I sensed he meant me no harm.
You carry great darkness in your heart, and if you do not release it, it will claim your soul.
The sound of his voice put some kind of ancient Indian spell on me. As his story unfolded in my mind.
You will come to this place again and kill many more men, and the darkness will grow until it consumes everything that you are. The soul will have no rainbow, the eye have no tears.
He said I was a great warrior, a coyote man, unequaled by any other pale-faced warrior, or something like that.
The snakes will bite shadows of your past until a venom poisons your heart and an echo of the song of the dead summons the spirits deep from within the mountains.
I didn't quite get what he was saying, but there was definitely snakes. And indeed, his warriors surrounded me and attacked me like hungry wolverines. They couldn't stop me, though, and Grey Wolf wasn't in the mood for idle talk. Couldn't see any way out of this trap. But suddenly, one just appeared. Kinda like a miracle. I felt like I would be lost in that damn cave forever. Finally, I found myself back outside, perched on the edge of a precipice, overlooking a thundering white water river. To get where I was going required several leaps of faith, but no way in hell I was turning back. I chased after him, determined to make him explain the meaning of all that mumbo-jumbo.
Mumbo Jumbo is right. Are you making this all up as you go?
A few details may be fuzzy, brother, but I am relating exactly what happened. There were dozens of Apache warriors aiming at me from on high.
Dozens?
Well, maybe not dozens, but there was a lot of
them. That place is very full.
Well, more than that, little lady. A steep climb up creek ahead of me and scrambled up those rocks like a mountain goat. I was determined to locate Grey Wolf and find out exactly what the hell he was trying to tell me. And wouldn't you know it, that crafty son of a bitch led me right into a trap.
What kind of trap?
Well, son, there had to be at least 100 Apaches surrounding me.
100?
God be my witness.
Oh, come on. Who you kidding?
Hey, I believe you. Come on, tell us how it ended.
All right, but I'm not gonna drag this out. Where were we?
You were surrounded by 100 Apache warriors.
Well, I didn't take the time to count them exactly, but there were a lot of them.
Come on.
And in the end, a path appeared before me that I had not seen before. I followed it as I desperately needed to find out what Grey Wolf was trying to tell me. But it was like that son of a bitch disappeared into thin air. Never did find him. And never did collect my goddamn bounty.